Next, glandular epithelium. Glandular epithelium. Some cells of the cuboidal or columnar cells. Some cells of the cuboidal or columnar cells modify to form secretory functions. Secretory functions. These are called glandular cells. These are called glandular cells. These forms glandular epithelium. The glands are mainly two types. These are unicellular glands and multicellular glands. Unicellular glands, these are isolated glands. Isolated glands. Examples, goblet cells. Goblet cells. These single goblet cells secretes mucus. Secretes mucus. These cells modified glandular cell. These columnar or cuboidal cell modified into glandular cells. These are single cells, so called these are unicellular glands. Examples, goblet cells. Goblet cells. Goblet cells secretes mucus. Next, multicellular glands. Multicellular glands. These are the clusters of cells. These are the clusters of cells. Group of cells. So these are called multicellular cells. Example, salivary glands. Salivary glands. Goblet cells are examples of unicellular glands. Salivary glands are examples of multicellular glands. Multicellular glands. Next, based on the mode of pouring or releasing. Based on the mode of pouring or releasing, the glands are two types. These are exocrine glands and endocrine glands. Exocrine glands and endocrine glands. Exocrine glands. Exocrine glands are duct glands. Duct glands. Endocrine glands are ductless glands. Ductless glands. These secretes saliva. Saliva, tears, saliva, tears, digestive enzymes, digestive enzymes, earwax, earwax. Exocrine glands are duct glands. These secretes saliva, tears, digestive enzymes and earwax Endocrine glands, the secretions of endocrine glands are hormones. Hormones. Endocrine glands release their secretions directly into the blood vessels. Directly into the blood. Directly into the blood. Exocrine glands releases these secretions into the ducts. Into the ducts. These are transported to the target organs by ducts. These endocrine glands are, the secretions of endocrine glands are transported to the target organs by the blood. By the blood. Based on the mode of secretion, the exocrine glands are further divided into three types. Neurocrine gland, apocrine gland, holocrine gland. Neurocrine gland, which release the secretory granules without damage of their cells. Without damage of their cells. For example, pancreas. In neurocrine gland, the secretions, the secretory substance releases without damage of the cell. Without damage of the cell. Apocrine glands. Apocrine glands. The apical surface of the apical part of these cells pitched up. Pitched up. The secretory substance are released by the pitched of the apical part of the cells. Apical part of the cells. Examples, mammary glands. mammary glands. Next, holocrine gland. Holocrine gland. In holocrine gland, total cell is disintegrate to the excretory contents. Total cell is disintegrate. Example, sebaceous glands. Merocrine, without damage of cell. In merocrine, without damage of cell. In apocrine, the apical part is damaged. The apical part is damaged. Holocrine, total cell is disintegrates. Total cell is disintegrates. Important. Merocrine example pancreas. Apocrine examples mammary glands. Holocrine examples sebaceous glands. These are the glandular epithelium. Next, compound epithelium. Compound epithelium is formed by the more than one layer of the epithelium. Compound epithelium is made up of more than one layer. It is limited role in absorption and secretion. Important. Compound epithelium limited role in absorption and secretion. The main function of compound epithelium is protection of chemical and mechanical stress. Protection from the chemical and mechanical stress. Compound epithelium is divided into stratified squamous epithelium, stratified cuboidal epithelium, stratified columnar epithelium. Stratified squamous epithelium, stratified compound squamous epithelium is keratinized and non-keratinized. Stratified squamous epithelium is divided into keratinized and non-keratinized based on the presence of keratin. In keratinized stratified epithelium contains keratin protein. This keratinized stratified squamous epithelium located on the dry surfaces of the skin, dry surface of the skin, palms and the soles, etc. Next, non-keratinized stratified squamous epithelium present in the moist surface of the buccal cavity, pharynx, esophagus, vagina and anal canal. Non-keratinized squamous epithelium. In non-keratinized squamous epithelium, keratin is absent. It is present in the moisture surfaces. Important. Non-keratinized squamous epithelium present in the moist surfaces, that are buccal cavity, pharynx, esophagus, vagina and anal canals. Very very important. Keratinized and non-keratinized, these are helps for the protection. This makes the skin waterproof. Keratinized stratified squamous epithelium makes the skin waterproof. Next, stratified cuboidal epithelium. Stratified cuboidal epithelium present in the large ducts of salivary glands, ducts of sweat glands and pancreatic ducts. Stratified columnar epithelium present in the conjunctiva of eyes and pharynx. Next, transitional epithelium. Transitional epithelium present in the wall of the urinary bladder. This transitional epithelium takes 5 to 7 layers. When urinary bladder is filled with urine, these layers are stretched. These layers are appears 1 or 2 layer thickening. 1 or 2 layers thickening. Next, pseudo stratified epithelium. Pseudo stratified epithelium is a simple epithelium. Pseudo stratified epithelium is simple epithelium, but it appears compound epithelium. Because the arrangement of nucleus, on the basement membrane, appears more than one layer, So this looks like a stratified epithelium, but this epithelium is simple epithelium. So this epithelium is called pseudo stratified epithelium. All cells are rest on the basement membrane. The pseudo stratified epithelium is ciliated and non ciliated pseudo stratified epithelium. Pseudo stratified epithelium is divided based on the cilium, ciliated and non ciliated. This pseudo stratified epithelium contains goblet cells. In ciliated pseudo stratified epithelium present in trachea, there is cilia and the goblet cells. Are present in ciliated pseudo stratified epithelium. Present in the trachea. Next, non-ciliated pseudo stratified epithelium. There is no cilia, and no goblet cells. In non-ciliated epithelium, cilia and the goblet cells are absent. Non-ciliated pseudo stratified epithelium present in the epididymis. Next, cell junctions. The cells of the epithelium held together by a cementing substance. These substances are catharins proteins. The cell junctions are structural and functional links between the two adjacent cells for their specific needs. Cell junctions are, present in all epithelial cells, and some tissues, tight junctions, adhering junctions, gap junctions. These junctions prevents the leakage of water. For example, sweat glands. These glands makes the skin watertight. Next, adhering junctions. Cementing the neighboring cells together. These junctions, adhering junctions or desmosomes, helps act as rivets. That binds the muscle cells to sheets. The difference between adhering cells and the desmosomes. Adhering cells connects the microfilaments. Desmosomes connects the intermediate filaments. Present in the cells. These two helps for the keeping the neighboring cells together. Next, gap junctions. Gap junctions are called, these are gap junctions. Gap junctions are called communicating junctions. Gap junctions are called communicating junctions. Communicating junctions and cytoplasmic channels, continuous cytoplasmic channels. These channels helps for the movement of ions, movement of substance. These gap junctions present in the cardiac muscle. These gap junctions present in the cardiac muscle. These helps for the rapid conduction of impulse, rapid conduction of impulse. Rapid conduction of impulse.